It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
Hey guys, Tyler here. For this video, I'll be talking about this guy right here. Now, this guy has been the subject of controversy ever since 2015. And more recently, of course, like France, experienced yet another series of terrorist attacks. The first one, of course, happened with the guy for the free speech class. And the second one happened in Nice. And so for this video, I'll be talking about the hot takes that I found on social media. Because, oh my god, guys, like the hot takes are just super bad. Perspective. Instead of fighting systemic racism, France wants to reform Islam. First and foremost, it's not fair at all to compare American society with French society. Because you see, American society, we largely just, you know, depend largely on labels to identify people. We say white American, or black American, or Chinese American, or whatever type of American. In French society, however, they do the exact opposite. They label people as just French, and just French only. In other words, I do in fact believe that we could actually learn from France on this, because the only way to actually fight racism is not to judge people by their race and not to concentrate hardly on any type of racial feature for a person. Because if we want to fight racism, we need to stop using labels to identify, of course, our skin color and our race. Now, it's kind of strange and so bizarre that this headline just brought about, of course, like France and racial injustice, when in fact people on the streets in France right now are being murdered for their free speech. So I think the priority should be, of course, concentrating on free speech and not on American central issues. You cannot hate all Muslims for just two beheadings. That is true. We should in fact judge Muslims on an individual basis. However, you'll be lying, just absolutely lying to say that there has been, of course, just two beheadings. Because throughout the whole entire freaking like 20 plus years that I've been recognizing, there has been at least more than just two beheadings. More than two. So, even like in the early foundations of Islam, Muhammad himself beheaded like so many people. I could actually recall a story where he beheaded at least 600 and 900 Jews on a single day. So you cannot tell me that there's only two beheadings in Islam. These series of tweets are just a gem, really. Charlie Hebdo, fueling anti-Islam sentiments in France. Aragon, fueling religious extremism. These two are to blame for the new terrorist attack in Nice 06. Stop incitement on both sides. Opinion. Why is France targeted over and over again by violent extremists? An extreme form of secularism and embrace of blasphemy, which has fueled radicalism among a marginalized minority. And of course, the United Nations had to weigh in on this.
The High Commissioner strongly condemns the vicious killings of three innocent human beings, including two women, that took place in Nice yesterday, in addition to the horrendous murder in a similar manner of Samuel Paty 2 weeks ago. She's also very concerned that inflammatory rhetoric from very different perspectives is feeding the social, religious, and cultural divisions on which such violence thrives. Unfortunately, such divisions leading to hatred, violence, and death are being repeatedly stoked and restoked in the name of religion as well as in the name of freedom of expression. The High Commissioner is urging that we put a stop to this vicious cycle before yet more lives are lost. Political and religious leaders, as well as the media, should not only avoid inciting violence, hostility, or discrimination themselves, they should speak out firmly and promptly against hate speech. They should also make it very clear that violence cannot be justified by prior provocation. Individuals must be held accountable for their crimes, no matter who they are or what they believe. However, entire groups should never be stigmatized or have their human rights violated in any way because of such individual acts.
Honestly, I do not understand this argument that both sides are the same. Clearly, they're not the exact same thing. For starters, illustrators illustrate drawings for newspapers, for cartoons, whatever type of animation. With Islamic terrorists, they just go out and kill people because of their religious beliefs, right? So how can you possibly tell me that drawing a cartoon is the exact same equivalent as some terrorist killing an artist for his freedom of expression? Now, to me, if you go to a country, you should actually integrate into the society that you live in. So, if a Muslim comes from an Islamic country, right, they should integrate into French or Western society. And that includes allowing people to express their own personal points of views, no matter how offensive they could be. Yes, it's possible that you could practice your religion, that's fine, but religion, of course, is a private matter, and so you cannot force your own personal religious beliefs onto other people. So no matter how offensive a religious, you know, opinion is against something, you cannot kill somebody just because of that. And if you cannot actually accustom yourself to those kind of, you know, points of views that are different than yours, then by all means, just go back to your country, because honestly, I am so sick and tired of people trying to change the culture when they should be the one who actually respect the culture. When Justin Trudeau was asked about the recent events in France, he gave the most cuck answer imaginable.
Le président Macron, lui, dit qu'on devrait avoir le droit de se moquer de la religion, qu'on devrait avoir le droit de faire des caricatures du prophète Mahomet. Alors j'aimerais vous entendre, vous, ce que vous pensez là-dessus précisément. Est-ce qu'on doit, est-ce qu'on peut se moquer de la religion? Est-ce qu'on peut se moquer du prophète des musulmans?
Merci, Lina. D'abord, nous allons toujours défendre la liberté d'expression. C'est un droit protégé dans nos chartes des droits et libertés. C'est une valeur et un principe fondamental pour toute société libre, et nous allons toujours la défendre. Mais la liberté d'expression n'est pas sans limite. On n'a pas le droit, par exemple, de crier au feu dans un cinéma bondé de monde. Il y a toujours des limites. Mais dans une société pluraliste, diverse et respectueuse comme la nôtre, nous nous devons d'être conscients de l'impact de nos mots, de nos gestes sur d'autres, particulièrement ces communautés, ces populations qui vivent énormément de discrimination encore dans un système qui continue de discriminer. Donc, oui, nous allons toujours défendre la liberté d'expression, mais nous nous devons d'agir avec respect pour les autres et de chercher à ne pas blesser de façon arbitraire ou inutile ceux avec qui on est en train de partager une société et une planète.
Donc, je comprends que vous pensez qu'on ne devrait pas présenter des caricatures et se moquer de la religion. C'est ce que je comprends par votre comparaison avec crier au feu dans un cinéma bondé. Parce que la situation, on devrait avoir peur, quoi, des terroristes qui utilisent ce prétexte-là pour aller égorger des gens.
D'abord, je pense que dans une société comme la nôtre, on se doit de chercher toujours à être respectueux et de ne pas insulter les autres avec qui on partage une société. C'est une question de respect, c'est une question de ne pas chercher à déshumaniser ou à blesser délibérément. Je pense qu'il y a toujours un débat extrêmement important, extrêmement sensible à avoir sur des possibles exceptions, sur des enjeux où on ne veut pas blesser, mais souvent l'intention est moins importante et le fait peut quand même blesser. Et donc, dans une société qui se veut basée sur le respect de l'autre et l'écoute et l'apprentissage, ayons ces conversations complexes d'une façon responsable. Mais je vais répéter ce que j'ai dit hier, il n'y a absolument rien qui pourrait jamais justifier les actes terroristes affreux, épouvantables qu'on a vus en France et qu'on voit ailleurs dans le monde. C'est injustifiable et le Canada condamne de tout cœur ces actes en se tenant toujours avec nos amis français qui vivent des moments extrêmement difficiles. Nous nous devons en même temps de se souvenir que ces terroristes, ces criminels, ces meurtriers ne représentent aucunement une religion, ne représentent pas du tout les musulmans ici au Canada ou partout dans le monde. Et nous nous devons de ne pas les laisser représenter cette religion.
I just love, absolutely just love, how Justin Trudeau not only managed to dodge the question once, but also twice in a row, because almost every single time, and it's not just Justin Trudeau either, almost every time politicians get asked direct questions, they find weaselly ways to just avoid the question. Now look, I don't understand his answers at all, because he's saying that freedom of speech is not without consequence. Is he trying to say that if you criticize other religions, that of course is not covered underneath freedom of speech? Because yes, freedom of speech covers every single last aspect that could be a potentially offensive to somebody else. It's not just the pretty stuff that you hear in the streets, it's also the nasty stuff that you don't want to hear. And so yes, freedom of speech does in fact cover blasphemy, and to say that there's limitations, I'm sorry, either you're for freedom of speech or you're not, period. My letter to CEO Facebook Mark Zuckerberg to ban Islamophobia, just as Facebook has banned questioning or criticizing the Holocaust. you compare criticizing an ideology to freaking Holocaust denial. Wow. That is just some sort of like comparison. Like, first of all, we know for a fact that Islam is an ideology, is a religion, and so ideology and religions are subject to criticism. With Holocaust denial, we know that the Holocaust actually happened. That's historical fact. It's not an ideology subject to criticism. How can you compare the two? Also, there has been various reports across the news networks talking about how many Muslims are protesting against France after the events that happened against a French teacher for the free speech class. Now, what's the main reason why they're protesting? Well, it's because of this clip right here.
Avec tous les instituteurs et professeurs de France, nous enseignerons l'histoire, ses gloires comme ses vicissitudes. Nous ferons découvrir la littérature, la musique, toutes les œuvres de l'âme et de l'esprit. Nous aimerons de toutes nos forces le débat, les arguments raisonnables, les persuasions aimables. Nous aimerons la science et ses controverses, comme vous. Nous cultiverons la tolérance, comme vous. Nous chercherons à comprendre sans relâche et à comprendre encore davantage ceux-là qu'on voudrait éloigner de nous. Nous apprendrons l'humour, la distance. Nous rappellerons que nos libertés ne tiennent que par la fin de la haine et de la violence, par le respect de l'autre. Nous continuerons, professeur. Et tout au long de leur vie, les centaines de jeunes gens que vous avez formés exerceront cet esprit critique que vous leur avez appris. Peut-être certains d'entre eux deviendront-ils enseignants à leur tour. Alors, ils formeront des jeunes citoyens, à leur tour. Ils feront aimer la République. Ils feront comprendre notre nation, nos valeurs, notre Europe. Dans une chaîne des temps qui ne s'arrêtera pas, nous continuerons. Oui. Ce combat pour la liberté et pour la raison dont vous êtes désormais le visage. Parce que nous vous le devons. Parce que nous le devons. Parce qu'en France, professeur, les lumières ne s'éteignent jamais.
I honestly do not see what's wrong with that clip at all, because he was basically saying that we should stand in solidarity in the spirit of the teacher that was killed and murdered over free discourse showing the cartoon of the Prophet Muhammad in a free speech class. And it's just so sad, utterly sad, that there's just so many Muslims in different parts of the world protesting against the French government, all because of that speech. He was not going against the entirety of Islam. He was not going against all Muslims. He was saying, hey, look, let's stand in solidarity from one of our compatriots because he died for teaching, of course, education and still on. That to me is not divisive messaging. I don't understand why there are just so many protests out there right now. But what do you guys think about these crazy reactions? Please tell me in the comment section and down below. And I'll talk to you guys next time.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
He's your only black friend, so he's your best black friend. I won't trade him for another black friend. Because black friends are rare, as you should be aware. He smiles like Richard Pryor, so just sit and stare.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.